From the home of the PGA Tour's Valspar Championship, it's Z Golf Show. Hi, everyone, and welcome to Z Golf Show. I'm Rick Zurek, and we are here at the Copperhead Golf Course in Innisbrook Resort in Palm Harbor, Florida. Now, we are just outside of Tampa, and coming up March 14th through the 19th in 2023 is the Valspar, and it is a very colorful tournament because Valspar is a paint company, and they have colored murals and everything you could ever imagine. They call it the most colorful PGA Tour event of the year. And I tell you what, they have some fun at the Valspar. So Monday through Sunday, there's something going on all the time. And here, better to explain it, is the tournament director, Tracy West. Valspar 2023, tell us about, take us Monday through Sunday.
Sure. So we have a ton of activities planned. So really starting off Monday, there's a pro celebrity am that happens, but really Tuesday is when it kicks off for our general patrons to come. So a lot of practice rounds and things happen on Tuesday.
Is it still free Tuesday?
It is. It is free on Tuesday. Lots of practice rounds happening. We've got a junior clinic with over 400 kids planned coming, so two PGA Tour professionals will do that. Then we roll into Wednesday, which is the Championship Pro-Am. So a great opportunity to come out, get autographs, meet some of the PGA Tour players and so forth, so we're excited about that. Then the competition days, the 4 days, we kind of have a fun theme for each day. So Thursday, so many people don't know, but Rondé Barber is the general chairman of this tournament, and he obviously is now in the Pro Football Hall of Fame, class of 2023, so we're going to honor him in a big way on Thursday. So okay. We're inviting fans to wear their favorite Bucks gear or their Rondé Barber 20, obviously Bucks gear and so forth. We've got lots of fun surprises planned for him throughout the day, but it's going to culminate at 7 p.m. right after play is done with a big celebration on the 18th green. So we've got a lot of the Bucks legends coming, senior leadership from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. We've got a fun gate giveaway, but we're going to do something really fun and cool honoring Rondé on the 18th green on Thursday. Friday, St. Patrick's Day. Need we say more, right?
Really?
A lot of green beer, a lot of fun celebrations and
things. You're lucky to have it on the 17th.
Yeah, exactly. So that'll be a lot of fun on Friday. Saturday is our big concert day. So we've got Valspar Live. Darius Rucker is our talent. So anyone,
Hootie,
exactly. Anyone that has a tournament ticket is invited to that concert, complimentary. So that's the big thing on Saturday. And then Sunday, we're doing something really, really meaningful to us. We've got a really nice relationship with Feeding Tampa Bay. We're going to be collecting canned goods. So inviting all of our patrons to bring a can of food, and that will be collected and given to Feeding Tampa Bay. So, and then a ton of activities all throughout the week, obviously family fun zones, a lot of fun seating areas, great food and beverage. The tournament's a really happening place.
Everyone is a VIP at the Valspar Championship. Front row seats to the PGA Tour action. Darius Rucker at the Valspar Live Concert presented by Chick-fil-A. Free tickets to kids 15 and under. And we offer premium wines, beer, custom cocktails, and great eats while you stroll the world-class Copperhead course. Come for the birdies, stay for the party. March 14th through the 19th, and be a part of the most colorful PGA Tour tournament in the world. Tickets on sale now at valsparchampionship.com.
So if you didn't pick up on that, this is a golf tournament and a party at the same time.
Yeah, absolutely. It really is. You know, we'll have 144 tremendous PGA Tour professionals here competing for that person, the honor of winning the Valspar Championship. But there's a lot of fun activities for everybody. Kids 15 and under are free. We've got military, active duty, and retirees that are free. Different discounts for veterans and so forth. So we really welcome everyone. And we have a ton of people that come out. And it is a great atmosphere and a great party.
It is, you know, there's rooftop type activities, overlooks. I saw more grandstands. Did I see more grandstands today than you've ever had before?
Yeah, absolutely. It's a huge build out there. Basically, we've got a build on basically 15 out of the 18 holes, which is exciting. But a lot of fun areas for people to sit, our patrons to sit, not only watching golf, but enjoying great drink, great food, and so forth. We even have a fun tournament sub called the Birdie Sub by Publix, our Copperberry, our official tournament cocktail for the tournament, Frenchie's pool party, you know, great different types of food, you know, throughout the golf course. So it's a really fun, cool atmosphere.
I think they came up with a golf tournament just so they could have a party, folks. But it's going to be great. Hey, I look forward to it. I'm sure everybody else does. You saw the commercial, and go to the ticket information again was
ValspirChampionship.com.
Very good. All right, we'll see you here. Now, the field for the 2023 Valspar is being put together as we speak, but the 2021 and 2022 champion, Sam Burns, he'll be going for the rare three-peat because since World War II, only 10 players have won the three-peat. Three tournaments, the same tournament in the same 3 years. Well, we'll see. He'll compete against Jordan Spieth, former major winner. Also, Gary Woodland, former major winner. They'll all come down to the final three holes, and they'll all have to take on the snake pit. Now, the final three holes here at the Valspar are called the snake pit. Yep, you've got the striker right here. He is the guardian of the snake pit. The moccasin, the rattler, and the copperhead are among the most difficult finishing holes on the PGA Tour. So if you get out here and play sometime, beware of the snake pit. 16 plays about a 460-yard par 4, but you can cut the corner over the water here. Beware of the water, because the more you cut it, the tougher you're going to have to keep it on the fairway, which is not an easy thing to do here on 16. 17 is a 206-yard par 3, completely covered around the green by bunkers, left, right, and in the back. And this is a real decider, because you make birdie here, you've definitely got one up on the field. And then there's 18, a 448-yard par 4 uphill, tremendous finishing hole. They call this hole Copperhead. The golf course is called Copperhead, and it is quite the snake. It's a church pew bunkers on the right. There's bunkers on the left. That's off your tee shot. And then you got to go uphill to a green that is surrounded by bunkers. Tremendous finishing hole if you're coming out here to play sometime, or if you're watching on TV. The 18th hole here at the Copperhead course is awesome. Now, before you get to the snake pit, you have to contend with this hole. This is the 12th hole, a par 4. You can see the water carries all the way up towards the green. And then after that, you come over here to a peninsula-type green. You see the railroad ties. That's the 13th green with the Valspar behind it. Two excellent holes here, 12 and 13. Now, as you heard Tracy West say, that Rondé Barber, who is the chairperson here at the Valspar, and very much involved with the Copperhead Group and their charitable donations. They're the group that really puts this thing together and makes it happen. So Rondé, who is the chairperson, was also elected into the Pro Football Hall of Fame, and Thursday will be his day here at the Valspar in 2023. We had a chance to talk with him and see what was his reaction when he found out he was elected as the newest member of the Pro Football Hall of Fame.
I cried a little, hugged my wife and my best friends that were there, and said, finally, you know, I'm that guy, you know that. Took me a long time to get to where I am, but I truly believed I was going to get there, so it wasn't a surprise.
But it hard to keep a secret?
It was impossible to keep a three-week secret that I was, it was in Hall of Fame, but it didn't stop me from celebrating it. I did a lot before the honors. I spent some time with some close friends, and just waited for the world to find out.
Have you even begun to formulate a speech or have an outline?
I won't bias myself by watching somebody else. At least I'll try not to. I have a platform. You know, I'll have my 8 to 10 minutes. I don't know if I'll take that long. But I do have a lot to say. I don't think I was expected to be a Hall of Famer. If you would have gone back to when Nelson was here in 1997, I wasn't playing. But 15 years on, you know, it turned itself into a pretty good career. And I'm glad that journey is over. So I get bothered a lot during Valspar. I won't say bothered. I get stopped a lot during Valspar week. I imagine it'll be a thousandfold this time, but like it's like Sam said in when he was congratulating me, I have a great platform, and I'll use it for as such. This tournament's been so good to me. I've been now part of the board for 9 years, and as my second year as general chair, this just adds to that. It gives me an opportunity to further emphasize the charities that we touch every single year, along with putting on a pretty fun event year in and year out. This championship is everything to me. I think you guys know that by now. But being a Hall of Famer will only enhance that.
Has Blair measured you yet?
So there you have it, the 2023 Valspar Championship coming up March 14th through the 19th, right here at the Innisbrook Resort and the Copperhead Golf Course. Monday and Wednesday, Pro-Am days, come out, get your picture taken, have some autographs with some of the pros. Tuesday, it's free to come on in, so come in and check that out, check out some practice. Thursday, you've got the tribute to Rondé Barber after golf. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, the competition goes on with Sam Burns trying to make it a three-peat. Well, we hope you enjoyed this preview of the Valspar Championship, and we hope you'll get out here or at least watch it on television. I'm Riggs the Rec. We'll see you next time right here on Z Golf Show.
Heading down south to the land of the pines, I'm thumbing my way into North Carolina. Staring up the road and pray to God I see headlights. I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers. And I'm hoping for Raleigh, I can see my baby tonight.